Greetings, this is Lodril, and welcome to a let's try of Atom RPG Trudograd. Atom RPG, if you don't know anything about it, was a post-apocalyptic indie isometric turn-based role-playing game. It was kickstarted, and then it was out on early access, and then it was full released. I have a full playthrough on my channel if you wish to check it out. If not, just hang around and we'll check out this sequel slash expansion. This will come out on early access tomorrow, so May 11th. I will have a link below, you can check it out, and I was sent the key for this. So let's just check it out. Now we'll create our own character. Ooh, and we start level 15. Interesting. Dragon, sure. So we don't start from scratch. We get two of these, I'm guessing. Let's see. Actually, let's start with this. Strength, carry weight was important in the previous game, and also melee was really important, so we'll put at least one point there. Endurance, maybe not. Dexterity, for sure. Intellect, for sure. Man, all of these are nice. Basically nothing. Maybe we can drop luck a bit. I don't think there is anything we can drop that will not harm us significantly. And I want all of this. These are all really good. I can drop strength, maybe. And go for guns. So, get more dexterity. Accuracy in melee combat. How about ranged combat? I mean, that should be accuracy in ranged combat. Oh, it's attention. Alright. So maybe we'll do that. And we'll put one more there. Okay, yeah, let's try that. We'll see how it goes. So we have two abilities to pick. Distinctions. Think of them as traits. Oh man. This gives +2 to characteristics. That's crazy. That is really good. All range weapons -35. Oh my god, no. Sexy beast. Personality +2. Personality -1 when talking to your own gender. I think I had this in my previous playthrough. I'm not sure. Oh my god, no. 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 That's not bad. I'm not sure what sequence is. I don't see it. So. Trading was really important in the previous game. This is gonna be an episode of me tinkering with the character creator. Trading was really important because at some point you got really good money and you could have the best weapons and armors, but mainly you needed bullets, so you needed to always have that nail. Man, these minuses... No. I hate having minuses on a character. Okay, what the hell is sequence? Represents the turn order. Oh, so you play later on. Okay. And all this, I don't see anything that is not really bad on your other skills. Minus one strength, minus one endurance, minus 15 to all skills. This is not that bad, but no. Luck minus 2. Sequence minus 7. We have 12. That means we'll play last. Oh my god. I don't know. I guess we might pick this again. Which might screw us up at some point. Which it did in my previous playthrough, but all ranged weapons. No. I want this, but for ranged weapons. Like the opposite. I don't care about crafting, but I do care about technology. I'm gonna play kind of the same character as I did in my previous playthrough. Weapon skill is minus 10, it's not that bad. But minus 5 in sequence and minus 1 in strength. We do get personality plus 2, which goes to 8, and attention plus 1, which also goes to 8. Which is really good, actually. Yeah, you know what? What the hell? We'll do that. We'll spend points on them. Alright, why do I start with a lot of martial arts and melee, but not not weapons? Don't know. Alright, let's see. Let's start with... We'll put everything on guns. I'm not sure what kind of guns we'll have, so I'm not sure. Throwing, I don't care. I want technology, because it's really important. Tinkering, I don't care. Pickpocketing, I don't care. All of this, I don't care. Let's go speedcraft to 8. Oh, yes, to 80. Should I locket picking? Yeah, lock picking is always important in all these games. Let's put it to 60. And then put this. Let's just be good at killing things. Even with a minus. Alright, put some more. I put this on 70. Okay. I put everything else on splits. Cool. Alright, this is new. This is a different way to do this, I guess. So, let's see. We have survival, martial arts, pistols, and SMG. Automatic firearms, rifle and shotguns, tinkering and throwing weapons. Tinkering was really problematic for me in the previous game. I'm not sure if they have really worked on this. Probably they have. We'll see. Let's see. Medicines heal plus 1 hit points for every level. plot armor. You get plus one to avoid knockdown for every level until the bonus reaches 20%. That's not bad. Knockdown was really hard. Damage support to body parts plus 8%. Martial arts damage. Yeah, let's start with pistols. It's only 10% at maximum though. How many of these do I have? 45? Holy shit. Is this one, if I learn it? Wow, it is one. 45 is an immense amount. We're starting really, really strong, apparently. Aha, on level 2 you get 2. I see, okay. So let's get the, at minimum, the level 1 traits or abilities. And I'm gonna take tinkering just in case tinkering is actually good now. We can try it out. I won't take throwing though. I don't know if we start with firearms or not, that's my problem. Inflict panic when shooting in burst for every second level. Minus one to burst spread. Plus one knockdown. Each bullet in the burst gives plus 4% to damage dealt to all the next ones. Ooh, that's nice. Oh man. There are so many good things here. Not sure. Alright, this is probably a bug. Perks TR3 butter info. Probably not what it should say there. We don't know what this is, basically. Why would you have a shotgun handicap if someone is close? Alright, let's see tinkering. More discounts. Double the items. Stealth bonus might be nice, I'm not sure. Damage resistances, sure. Ooh. Plus 1 kilo to carry weight and plus 1 health point for every level. So that's plus 15 right there. Fuck yeah. Damage resistance increased 2%. Ooh, that's nice. Common poisons no longer lower your health points. Okay. This is a very middle of the road character, but it's early access, so who cares? And 1 for 3. Sure. Okay, are we good? I think we're good. Alright, game mode. Easy. Normal. Saving only outside of battle. You know what? I wouldn't have finished the first game if I couldn't save in battle, so we'll go for normal. Unused parameters, talents too. What talents? 0-0. Zero distinctions. Oh, alright. Let's put that. Okay. All right. We're getting cutscenes. With a real video. Why is this so low suddenly? I'll have to up the volume again. I'm not sure why it was so loud before and not so low. I hate it when games have different mixing for different parts of the game. Which was ran by a certain professor Gorechu. As you know, Trudograd survived the war much better than most cities and towns of our motherland. Thus, it is possible that the facility still stands or even operates protected by the city walls. This facility is very important to our cause. Before the war, it was used to manufacture an experimental electromagnetic propulsion device, the RR1 railgun. According to top secret documents we uncovered during our research, this invention of Professor Gorachev was able to deliver special polymer-based projectiles straight into Earth orbit, or even further into outer space at tremendous speeds. If this information can be trusted, this device might just happen to be humanity's sole chance at destroying the asteroid before impact. Your mission is to venture into Trudograd, find Professor Gorachev and scout out the inverter facility for any traces of the RR1 railgun. If the propulsion device will be found, we will take it from there, securing and transporting it to HQ for further study and usage against the asteroid menace. Good luck, Major, and let there be Atom. Look at how loud this is compared to the previous thing. All right, let's see. Is this voice acted?
Crackling wood and the hiss of boiling sap are the only sounds in your tiny campsite. With a sigh, you stretch your back and gaze over at your surprised guest. He's a short fellow, hunchbacked and raggedly dressed. He emerged from the tall trees about an hour ago and asked if he could warm his bones by the fire. Surprisingly, you disregarded your hard-earned knowledge of the wastes and agreed. Now, he's sitting on the opposite side of the fire, his face hidden in the shadows of a hood. His silence is unnerving. You begin to regret.
What the fuck?
Maybe saying something would help ease the tension?
Sure, let's offer food.
The stranger raises his head and looks at you through the flames. At least it feels as if he's looking at you. His face is still obscured by shadows. No, thank you. I'm not hungry, he says in a calm and surprisingly soothing voice. A moment later, he asks, did you come here from far away? As it does to us all, the man is quiet again, but then throws a dry stick into the flames.
From what I remember, the previous game did not have voice acting.
City to the west of here.
knows why.
Perhaps telling someone about your adventures will make them.
I see. This is basically our picking what happened in the previous game. I don't know if the game, when it comes out, will have an import save. But for now, I guess you pick your choices. Of course, who remembers what the hell I did? I think Atom took control. The hive mind wasn't it for sure. The gangs wasn't it for sure. So it's either Atom or nothing changed. I think it's Atom, because I was trying to go for a Walls of Bitter settlement, stuff like that.
Good old Atom. Hey, guess those army boys got tired of riding in the back seat. The stranger adjusts his hood and sinks down into his tattered clothes.
Say, the voice acting is not great, though.
Old Bruiser Dan, the leader of the factory gang?
Yeah, I didn't kill him, actually.
That's good, the man says with a slight shiver. Silence once again descends upon your small camp until the sound of wolves howling arises in the distance.
There is a problem with this reading because the intonations are weird. Like, this sounds like it's not voice acted by an actual actor, which might be the case, right? This is early access, so. So maybe it's some of the developer doing the voice acting, just as a placeholder. Katia, yeah, Katia's the leader.
You cannot fathom why you're sharing everything that happened 2 years ago with this stranger. It's as if an unseen force is compelling you to speak the truth. Or perhaps this force is somehow turning lies into truth. What happened to the trading hub called Paragon? Can you tell me that? I'm glad to hear not all is lost in that corner of the wastes. The man stretches his arms up as the pluck of
lore. Oh man.
Tell me.
I did all of those.
Back then. I know it's a personal question, but indulge me.
It's a weird question because I had both Fidel, Hexogen and Alexander. Hexogen had he was a former writer and he was really, really good with sniper rifles and stuff like that. Alexander had his memory eaten by a worm, I think, which was one of the strangest storylines on the previous games. One of the best, actually, for me. It was really, really creepy and mysterious. I really liked it. Let's go with the Exogen. We can pick all of them. Cool.
Anyone else? The worm guy, huh?
It mentions that. Nice. I really like that it mentions that. Actually, I had a dog too, but I guess I can't pick that.
The man nods and again gazes down into the fire.
The worm guy.
Water flask and hold it out to share. He shakes his head no. 5 hard minutes of silence follows until you've had your fill of waiting and guessing. You lean forward. Focus exactly on the darkness within the man's cowl, and in a stern voice asks,
"Who am I talking to?"
Over the years, people have given me many different names. Your guest states without emotion, but isn't it true that names, like other words, have no intrinsic meaning? Words are senseless unless living people recall them and give them purpose. Thus, when we meet again, I will once more become nameless.
What?
Of its own accord, your companion's hood slides limply away. But it's absent.
What the fuck?
But a glowing, undulating sphere of crimson fire. A deadly star. You yelp aloud for a moment, willing yourself to run. But already the night has vanished, dissolved in the haunting red glow. Never again shall you be able to hide from the invisible gaze of your nightmarish guests. That gaze is cruel and indifferent, and the lands it oversees are barren, burnt down to nothing but ashes and splinters of stone. You are so entranced by the endless landscape of utter obliteration that at first you do not notice how your own body has started burning. You are obliterated.
ablaze on the inside, like a bunch of cinders twisted into human form. And the wild, frigid winds scatter your ashes across the surface of the dead earth.
And wake up. They definitely have gone way more cinematic with this game compared to the previous one. Whoa, have a radio. Nice. And now we have our choices coming into play. Oh, and we have a portable computer too. Upgrades. Okay. Hide the equipment we gave you. To view your characteristics, quest, current time, local map, press K or click on the interface button over there, I guess. All right. The game looks better too. Nice. Let's see. Alright, characteristics, abilities, statistics. Find the railgun. Find the professor. Okay. I didn't mean to move. I didn't know you can do that. Alright. Alright. Let us save and end the first episode here. Thanks for watching. Feel free to follow if you want to. You can find the link in the description below when you can check the game out if you want to yourself. Otherwise, hopefully I can see you in the next episode. Bye bye.